Thank you. friends, we gather to celebrate the marriage of Brandie and Edward, to witness their vows, their pledge of support, and to seek God's blessing upon them. From the beginning, God created us for a relationship and kept covenant with us. Jesus gave himself in love and taught us to continually forgive. And the Holy Spirit given in baptism renews God's grace within us day by day, enabling us to grow in faith, in hope, and in love. Those who marry are called to a way of life marked by grace, fidelity, and mutual respect as they bear one another's burdens and share one another's joys. As Brandie and Edward make their promises today, families are joined, friendships are strengthened, and a new community of love is formed. So let us surround them with our affection and our prayer, giving thanks for their love for one another and for all the ways that God's love is made manifest in our lives. Let us pray. Gracious and holy God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look with kindness upon Brandie and Edward, who come seeking your blessing. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them so that with steadfast love they may honor the vows they make this day through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Brandie, understanding that God has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter into this covenant? Do you?
I do.
And Edward, understanding that God has ordered, created, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you affirm your desire and intention to enter into this covenant? Do you?
I do.
I would ask Brandie and Edward's families, do you give your blessing to Brandie and Edward and promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in their marriage? Do you?
I do.
And will all of you who are witnessing these vows today do everything in your power to uphold Edward and Brandie in their marriage? Will you?
So Brandie and Edward, I have two scripture readings today, both words from the Apostle Paul, both scriptures where he is talking about love. One quite familiar that you hear in a lot of weddings, and the second maybe not quite so familiar. Because 1 Corinthians 13, I'm starting with a portion of that, and because that is so familiar and used at so many weddings, I'm reading it, a paraphrase of it, from The Message by Eugene Peterson, and the Romans passage as well. So hear God's word to you and to all of us this day. If I speak with human eloquence and angelic ecstasy, but don't have love, I'm nothing but the creaking of a rusty gate. And if I speak God's word with power, revealing all God's mysteries and making everything plain as day, and if I have faith that says to a mountain, jump, and it jumps, but I don't have love, I'm nothing. If I give everything I own to the poor and even go to the stake to be burned as a martyr, but I don't have love, I've got nowhere. So no matter what I say and what I believe and what I do, I am bankrupt without love. Love never gives up. You two know that. Love cares more for others than for self. Love doesn't want what it doesn't have. Love doesn't strut, doesn't have a swelled head, doesn't force itself on others, isn't always me first, doesn't fly off the handle, doesn't keep score of the sins of others, doesn't revel when others grovel. Love takes pleasure in the flowering of truth, puts up with anything, trusts God always, always looks for the best, never looks back. Love keeps going to the end. And a few verses from Romans 12. Love from the center of who you are. Run for dear life from evil. Hold on to dear life, to good. Be good friends who love deeply. Practice playing second fiddle. Don't burn out. Keep yourselves fueled and aflame. Don't quit in hard times. Pray all the harder. Help needy people. Bless your enemies. No cursing them under your breath. Laugh with your happy friends when they're happy. Share tears when they're down. Get along with each other. Don't be stuck up. Make friends with nobodies. Don't be the great somebody. Discover beauty in everyone. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So, Brandie, let me just say to you that you look a lot different today. All dressed up, so exquisitely beautiful, than how you used to look the second week of June here at Western Boulevard Presbyterian. All dressed up as Abraham or Moses, a shepherd. I think there was one summer you were a sheep. For many, many years, you and Morgan were my dedicated right-hand women in the Bible story room of Vacation Bible School, helping to bring Bible stories to life for the young children of this church. And what a joy it was to see a young child's face light up when you acted out ancient words, teaching some important truth as you lived out the story in front of them. So many of those stories, as you know, were defining the nature of God's love to the children, a particular kind of love that God deeply desires in all of our relationships. And then often the week after Vacation Bible School, you and Edward would journey together with the youth of this church to some place of great suffering to continue to live out the story of God's love, showing through your sacrificial service by laying a floor or painting or putting a new roof on a house that had been destroyed in a hurricane, showing God's love through your actions. And so here you are today, all dressed up as bride and groom, living out another beautiful love story and preparing to vow that this story will never end, which it will not, if it's based in the particular kind of love that Paul describes in 1 Corinthians 13 and Romans 12. You see, love was such an incredibly important concept to the ancient Greeks, that's the language, the original language of the New Testament, that they had numerous words to define it, in contrast to the one word that we use. There was philia, which designated friendship, love. There was eros, from which we get the word erotic, a romantic, passionate, sexual sort of love. Many people get married based on eros. They're feeling it. Woo! Eros is great. It is an exhilarating emotion. But you and I know that emotions come and go. And so that's why marriages based solely on eros tend not to last. And then there was agape, a very different kind of love. And this is the love that Paul is highlighting in 1 Corinthians 13 and Romans 12. Agape is best described as unconditional love. It is a committed decision to act in love toward another person, despite your feelings or their behavior or their worthiness. It is a selfless, sacrificial, boundless love, always, always giving, never expecting anything in return. Jesus Christ is the quintessential picture of agape love, reaching out to others with love and acceptance, no matter their race, status, or creed, bringing healing and wholeness, laying down his life so that others, even his enemies, might have life. So Brandie and Edward, only agape love will bind the two of you together until death do you part. To build the foundation of your marriage on any kind of love other than agape is like building a house on the sand. When the storms of life come, as you know they will, the house will not stand. How will you cope if, God forbid, one of you gets fired one day, or one of you gets diagnosed with a life-threatening illness? What will you do when some cold gray morning you wake up and turn over and look across the bed at the other and say to yourself, why am I still married to this person? How will you manage when your parents suddenly require the kind of care that they provided you when you were just a babe in diapers and now they're the ones wearing diapers? Paul tells us that even in the midst of catastrophic changes like these, there is a love that bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. And so this is what you're doing here today, making a commitment to agape love, which is actually rooted in the vows that you are about to make, that you will love each other unconditionally, no matter what, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live. So in closing, let me say this. From this day forward, as you two love each other from the center of who you are, unconditionally and faithfully and sacrificially, you will be a sign to the world that true happiness is found not in power or in prestige or in possessions, but in agape love. And boy, does our world desperately need a sign that love can overcome hate, that generosity is more powerful than greed, that peace can prevail over violence, that difference is good and God-given. And what you do together here today, and what you do tomorrow, and what you do for the rest of your lives, you too will be a sign of hope for the world. So whether dressed up or dressed down, may you continue to live out an amazing agape love story for the hope of your never-ending life together and for the hope of the world. May God bless you both. So, Brandie and Edward, since it is your intention to marry, I invite you now to turn towards each other, pass off flowers, and join your right hands, or join both hands, and with your promises, bind yourselves to each other as husband and wife. Edward, if you would repeat after me. I, Edward, take you, Brandie.
I, Edward, take you, Brandie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
And I promise before God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Brandie, if you'll repeat after me. I, Brandie, take you, Edward.
To be my husband.
And I promise before God and these witnesses. To be your loving and faithful wife. In plenty and in want. In joy and in sorrow. In sickness and in health. As long as we both shall live. So what do you bring as a sign of your promise to each other this day? Let us pray. By your blessing, O God, may these rings be to Brandie and Edward symbols of unending love and faithfulness, reminding them always of the covenant they have made this day. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So Edward, if you'll take Brandie's ring and repeat after me. Brandie, this ring I give you.
Brandie, this ring I give you.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Brandie, if you'll take Edward's ring, repeat after me. Edward, this ring I give you.
Edward, this ring I give you.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
As a sign of our constant faith and abiding love.
In the name of the Father. And of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Let's all turn once again to God in prayer. Eternal God, thank you for all the ways you fill our lives with love, and especially for the love you have given to Brandie and Edward. Bless them in their life together, that their love for one another may deepen and their trust in you may grow. Give them wisdom in their common life and nurture them in your grace. When they hurt one another, enable them to show mercy. May they bear one another's burdens and share in each other's joys. Fill their home with love. And let their marriage be a gift to all who know them. Make their life together an expression of your own love for this world, that in their esteem for one another, in their care for their neighbors, in their service to those in need, all will see a glimpse of your coming reign of justice, peace, and love. Bless those gathered here today, that all who witness these vows may find their hope renewed and know the depth of your love and care for them and for this world which you cherish. All praise to you, Triune God, who created us for love, became love for the world, and nurtures love in us all. And we conclude our prayers by saying together the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Before God and in the presence of this congregation, Brandie and Edward have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. Therefore, I proclaim that they are now married. Brandie and Edward, you have both been loved into being by your families, by your friends, and by one another. Always remember that above all else, you have been loved into being by a gracious and loving God who will never forsake you in your life together. As God's own, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, and patience, forgiving each other as the Lord has forgiven you, and crown all of these things with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. May the grace of Christ attend you, the love of God surround you, the Holy Spirit keep you, that you may live in faith, abound in hope, and grow in love now and forever. Amen. You can kiss if you want. All right, you get your bouquet back. And turn and face these fine folks. And my friends, it is my pleasure to introduce to you Brandie and Edward Johnson. Wait until she gets to the back.